Out of problems at a school in the southwest suburbs, racially fueled tensions started a brawl, and that led hundreds of students to stay home and others to protest outside.
WGN's Mike Lowe is live in Tinley Park now with more. Hi, Mike.
Micah and Joe, good evening to both of you. After a series of incidents here at Andrew High School, there was a fight in the hallways. People say it led to a clash in between class. This video, provided by a parent and recorded by a student, shows students shouting, shoving, and swinging at each other. Parents say it's the culmination of days of racial incidents and bullying. In response, a group of students protested outside of the school, denouncing hate and demanding justice.
We ask this administration to embrace its students' diversity and work to make the school a safe, inclusive, welcoming, and equitable space for everyone.
But even as some students demanded equal treatment, others could not agree on who exactly qualifies.
You said something with the LGBTQ community, whatever. We don't support that.
Parent Tamika Howard said Andrew High School has become a microcosm of the division and resentment pulsating through American life.
It's no hidden secret that a lot of people, Caucasians, may not want people like me here.
The racial tension was simmering when a video posted to social media showed a white student in blackface. Then things boiled over with white students allegedly burning a Quran.
So obviously it's going to piss us off. Yeah, it's our religion.
There was a fight going on between people disrespecting us, people disrespecting, and then we got mad. Obviously we're going to do something about it.
The school has not confirmed that a Quran was burned, but several students and parents say that's what led to the fight and subsequent suspensions of some of the students. But according to protesters, discipline was not equal.
Three kids got suspended and the white kids got no punishment.
Then there were more postings on social media and threats that someone would bring a gun to school. Today, the school's principal said more police were on hand and 400 students stayed home amidst the threats.
We are not immune to the hate and intolerance in our world. That said, I know we can address this and celebrate all of our kids, no matter their race, religion, gender, or orientation.
But Howard says it'll take more than a reassuring voicemail to reduce the charged atmosphere.
The school is taking mild baby steps to a situation that needs more, they need actions now.
And the students who are out here protesting today tell us they will be back out here demonstrating again tomorrow. Reporting live tonight in Tinley Park, Mike Lowe, WGN News.